The Eagles will need to be on top of their game if they want to come away with win number 9 on the season. It's the Falcons going up against the Eagles. With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, Larry. It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look live there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Today we hit week 10, and we've got a good one in store between the Atlanta Falcons and the Philadelphia Eagles. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Eagles team as they interplay here. They're halfway home, looking good at a perfect 8-0.
And not much to complain about so far, is there? I'd have to say they're the best team in the NFL through the first half of the year.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Falcons, they were losers their last time out. They're going to try to get back in the win column, but obviously they're going to have to do that in a hostile environment.
And sometimes that actually works to your advantage. Now you've got to band together your team, the us against the world mentality. Let's see if they can use it and get a victory.
So here come the Falcons now to get the football for the first time. They'll be led out by the former third-round pick from Colorado State. It's Garrett Grayson.
Well schooled in pro-style offense while Colorado State, he was the third quarterback taken in the 2015 draft behind Jameis Winston and Marcus Mariota.
They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30. Timmy Jernigan, the Florida State man, in on the stop. And how about this wide receiving core, Charles?
Well, I was at the hotel watching a little film, and you popped your head in and said, these receivers are pretty good from what I can tell. You're exactly right. Can't wait to see them do their thing out on the field.
Here we go with 2nd and 7. Freeman again. And oh, right away, he lost the football. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. And without a doubt, not the way they pictured that opening drive unfolding.
No, they were making progress. They weren't exactly in high gear. But they were making a few yards along the way. And now that they've coughed it up, they can go back to the sidelines and regroup a little bit.
Give them 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. And they tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to.
Good use of the pass there to pick up the first down against a defensive look that they had specifically prepared for, they told us, coming into this one.
Certainly seems like they're holding all the right cards now, doesn't it? Because of their preparation. Went back, watched the tape, studied the tendencies, and they feel like they had them down cold, and they were able to use the pass against them.
On 2nd down, here's Smith. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. Nelson Aguilar, the intended receiver, and it's 3rd down.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense, but in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass. Excellent job. Way to knock it down.
A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th.
While we know that the identity of this offense is to throw the ball, they've got to run it every so often, if for no other reason than to tamp down the pass rush. They can't let them just tee off and get to their quarterback.
And his kick here is good. And the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. So the folks here in the stands this afternoon, they're happy about that when their guys get the early advantage after the opening drive field goal.
And they should be happy. Their guys look good getting down the field, and that's got to give them hope that good things are in store here today.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive? A little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown, but they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punching the end zone without turning it over.
Second down following the run. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
Now, that result is no surprise. This team is bringing back memories of what? The 85 Bears, the 2000 Ravens. Those teams were so great against the run, they made you abandon any plans of doing that when you played against them.
Now, Grayson. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. So on fourth down, the Falcons will call on Matt Bosher to punt it away. That's taken on the 25. Oh, it'll 360.
Oh, man.
Now Geno on first down, and the reception made by Alshon Jeffrey. It's a gain of 7, and it's a second down.
Quarterbacks like throwing the slant route, but they have to be careful about ball placement. They have to put it in a spot that makes sure the receiver has his body in front of the defender.
They come up in an offset eye. And the former Heisman winner, this is Mark Ingram. And the hole closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38. Paul Posluszny, the linebacker, brings him down. So they run it on second down. Now let's see what third down brings here for the offense. Now Geno. And Jeffrey's got it. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. And the head coach reaches... Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually challenge the play or not. In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. You throw that flag, you probably feel really confident. And then all of a sudden, boom, you lose the challenge.
Yeah, when you take a look at it, you're throwing that flag because you believe you're going to be right. And when it comes back the other way, you have to regroup.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Coleman now. And some room to maneuver. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. They get 6 here after the incompletion, and it'll leave them with a 3rd and 4.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play. First level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position ended up making the tackle. And oftentimes, we call them a hybrid. Combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
Smart approach there, using the run to pick up the first. And that was a defensive setup they prepared for this week, knowing that keeping it on the ground was the best way to attack it.
And that means also that they're able to read them pretty well. All the things they prepared for, when they get to the line of scrimmage, they see it in pre-snap recognition and know exactly how to attack based on...
And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
And the penalty now makes it first and 20. Throwing now is Geno. And that one falls incomplete. Try to dump it underneath. Now second down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that fell harmlessly to the ground. To throw on second down is Smith. This complete, left side to Aguilar. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. 23 yards on the play.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
Smith on first down, and he's got his man in stride, complete. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up the block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
And the offense lining up first and 10. The play clock's running down. From the red zone now, Smith. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
First down.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
Still 7 down.
And the seemingly endless drive continues. They'll fake the handoff. Now Smith looking for the end zone. Oh, he almost had it for the pick. A great chance there for the interception in the end zone. Instead, third down.
A missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off a drive. They had a chance there to finish things off. Didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys do not play offense.
He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Trey Boston. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on four, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it. Not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
but he
up.
He trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what is off. And oh, that is going to be a safety. And Charles, at some point, you can't keep worrying about big play. Can this be perfect? You just have to get the ball out of the end zone.
And in the offensive huddle, that was discussed when they called the play. Just get out of the end zone. But you know what's interesting? A lot of the times in the defensive huddle, they actually call a set and then say at the end of it, get a safety. So it's preached, it's coached, it's thought about.
So after that safety, now a free kick situation forthcoming as they punt it away from the 20. This is taken at the 23. And this is a guy who's been here enough. He can't use, hey, I'm a rookie as an excuse. He's been around.
He sat in the meetings. He's played the games. The coaching staff is showing much more confidence in him because the game plan has been expanded since the last time we saw him play.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Throws a quick hitter on the slant. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Still first down.
A shotgun snap for Smith. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line, hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
Second down, 8. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. They'll give it to him right up the gut. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8. And here now the defensive starters for Atlanta.
No surprise at all that a Penn State linebacker named Paul Posluszny usually leads his team in tackles.
And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on 3rd. And this is going to be incomplete.
Sometimes it looks pretty simple, batting the ball away, but oftentimes there's some pretty good teaching and practice that goes into it. Being able to get to the receiver, not interfere, and get his hands through the football and knock it away.
And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Yeah, here now come the Falcons. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered 2 points on the safety. They don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs.
Sure.
just messes things up for you offensively. But now they've got to go ahead, take it, set it aside, and move forward.
That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down.
I would not want to be an offensive lineman in today's NFL, especially not a center or a guard if you got to deal with these massive defensive tackles who could not just beat you with strength, but they can beat you with quickness and guile as well. They can get upfield and make plays. And a lot of times what they're taught, just go ahead and tackle everyone that comes in your area and keep the run with the ball. Man, there's no doubt the defense has to be excited after stacking up back-to-back running plays. But I still remember my old coaches saying, after you've had some success, you better be careful. They might have an answer for you. So make sure you watch your keys, play your techniques, and don't get overconfident.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And that is incomplete. Dez Bryant, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up a 4th down.
And that one was knocked away, and I think the defender's going to be a little upset with themselves. They made the play on the football, but that one felt like a forced pass by the quarterback. Thought he had someone open. He really wasn't. Maybe an example of having too much confidence in his receiver that no matter what, I'm going to throw it to him. And that was a play made by the defense, and it could have been a bigger one.
His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. Returnable here from the 38. Zach Ertz, and he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. So he got his hands a little too far outside. The ref caught him, threw the flag. The gun. Here's Smith. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up 2nd down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
And he's got his man on the comebacker.
So a little grabbing there, but this time it goes against the offense for holding. They come up in an offset eye. On second down, Ingram. Oh, a nifty juke there.
Not much fun for a guy trying to tackle him.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 12 yards is the pickup there, and it'll be a third and about 13.
But looks like they caught him off guard on second and very long by running the football. All right, we always talk about tendency breakers and counters and doing things opposite the grain, and that worked very well for him. Picked up really nice yardage, but it's got a lot of work to do on third down.
And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. Going old reliable there to the slot on third down.
And the slot position has become the bane of just about every defense's existence, because how do you cover? Do you go with the bigger guy to try and use size? Can't go to try go with the quicker guy, and sometimes you even get out quick there. Very difficult to match up with that slot receiver. That's why they keep going back to him.
And he's had the hot hand. Now a first down throw. It's Smith. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. The second-year man, Vic Beasley, in there to sack him for a loss of six. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football. So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Well, it's like that in just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it. Here's Donnie Jones now. On for his second punt, he'd take a repeat of his first.
Well, the great coach has said football's really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time we saw them go for it in kind of an unusual situation. It's not like it's a fourth quarter do or die. They went for it, didn't get it. We'll see how that affects them this go around.
Partner, I'm wondering if we're starting to see the effects of analytics coming into play here, where people are studying the number of possessions, how many times you should go for it, what position it leaves your team in. Maybe we're starting to see a little bit of that creeping into the NFL game.
Yeah, I think we've seen it in other sports, maybe into the NFL now as well. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
It takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver, because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone, sometimes you're throwing it between the zones, sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
And he's able to get up here to the 26. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
It's really simple to say that they know their identity, that they are a passing team. But one of the reasons that they're so successful, they know how to mix in the run and make sure that they keep the defense off balance and not able to just simply say, let's go get the quarterback and disrupt things.
And now a 10th carry for Freeman. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45.
Illegal block in the back. Offense. Still first down.
After the penalty, here's Freeman. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. Give him 5 yards there, and it'll bring up second down. And this defensive line will be looking to control the point of attack.
And that's what they've done throughout this season. This is a terrific unit. They play together very, very well, and they don't permit big plays to happen.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Deep drop. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense.
So roughing the passer, 15-yard penalty.
And you notice how the offensive line responded. A couple went to check on the quarterback, and a couple went to the guy who hit the quarterback. No one likes to see their quarterback hit.
They come up in an offset eye. They run. Devontae Freeman. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35. The tackle was made by Michael Bennett.
And that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
On second down, Freeman. And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with third and five. So second down was a run play. Now let's see what they do on third.
Well, so far, this game has gone the way the defense coordinator had hoped. They dictated things. They've not let him run the ball very well at all. They gave up a nice game there. I doubt it'll back off their confidence. They've played so well throughout this entire game.
And the yellow flag hurts this offense, and now they face a tough third down. Bryant spread out to the right.
Let's go! Detroit!
Grayson now. And this is going to be incomplete. Malcolm Mitchell out of the University of Georgia was the intended receiver. And it's fourth down. On fourth down, here's Matt Bosher on to punt. Back deep, Marcus Wheaton. And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
No gain on the play there. Second down. Well, at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
Now Wentz. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. Mike Wallace, the intended receiver, and it'll bring up third down. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. Now Wentz on third down. Finding time. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. And the dreaded face mask penalty, that's going to cost him 15 yards.
And it's such a dangerous play. Body going one way, and then your head gets yanked back the other. 15 yards is the right call.
On first down, it's Smith. And this is Ertz with it, right side. So oftentimes you see defensive holding. Here it's offensive holding for the flag. They'll run it now out of the gun. They find some open field here. It's a gain of 7 on the ground. Second down coming up.
And after that type of a run, there's some talking going on down on the field, but it's not trash talking. The guy who just carried the ball, he's going back and telling his offensive line, great job, keep it up, and we'll break that one soon.
Escaping the pressure right. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Tight, tight, watch flip. And they've got an extra defensive back out there now on third and 13. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Paul Posluszny. His guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
So it's third and long, and you know this is going to be a pass. So defensively, they're bringing an extra defensive back and just blanking the field. And this is an ill-advised throw right here as it winds up being picked off easily.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up. But you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over,
you didn't turn it over, right? You're giving your defense a chance. Because you're punting the ball away, and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. And wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a third and nine situation. So they've been unable to capitalize on the great field position as of yet. Here's third and nine. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've hit the end of quarter one. It's a close game here early on. EA Sports NFL Sunday returns following this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter. So they've been unable to capitalize on a great field position as of yet. Here's third and nine. Now flags come flying in. One of the Falcons moved early.
False start offense.
And the dreaded third and long here for the offense. Bryant spread out to the right. Now Grayson. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Timmy Jernigan able to track him down for a loss of 13. And it'll bring up fourth down. Well, they went with a nickel. They throw in an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down. You bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
Not going to get there. Not enough juice. An ambitious effort, but it's well short. And this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line.
Personal foul. Face mask.
And I know it's hard in live action, but you've got to keep your hands away from the face. That's a 15-yard penalty.
You work on it all the time, making sure your target area is lower and trying to keep your hands away from the face mask so you don't get the big penalty.
Here we go now.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. He's got time in the pocket. Wide open receiver complete. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10 to the 7. 26 yards on the pickup there. And the Eagles are now set up with a first and goal.
One of the feature points of the end route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
They come out here in the eye. Wentz. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Zach Ertz with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Eagles add on to their lead. And he's a reliable target. He's more than that, though. Hey, look, I'm not going to say he's the best tight end in the league, but he's solid.
Yeah, because he's able to block, and that's almost a lost art for a number of the tight ends in the league now, because the most popular guys are almost what we call move tight ends, more like receivers. But those guys who can do it all, there's still a place for them in the NFL.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. It's a very short kick taken by an up man. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And the last go-around for them, they tried that really, really long field goal, couldn't connect.
And in retrospect, I think a lot of people would say, well, why would you try one that long? You hurt yourself in field position, the ball comes out, you know, there. That only helps the other team. But I look at it as maybe it was a double shot of confidence. Confident the kicker could make it. And even if he missed, confident in their defense that they could hold them.
So pass interference on the defense, and Charles, this is a penalty we see all the time.
The offenses know what they're doing. They know how to create great matchups, and defenders, if you're not there in time, they will throw the flag.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
Here we go. 3-19.
Now Freeman, he's been busy today. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35. They'll need to get it to the 30 for a first. This is third down. Bryant spread out to the right.
Here we go now. Blue 90.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. The Falcons will call on Matt Bryant for the field goal try. From the left hash, this from 53 yards out. And his kick is good. Oh, he just did tuck it into the bottom of that left corner. And the drive will wind up yielding 3. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
And now the Eagles offense back out onto the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. He takes this up near the 25.
It'd be hard to say that a defense wouldn't be ready for a first down run. When you can gain that kind of yardage against a defense that's really kind of geared to stop that play, your confidence has to rise, and now you've actually opened up your playbook. You want to throw the ball now for play action, you're good to go.
Hurts over the middle. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
They run with Ajayi. A beautiful fake. And he's got the first down as he's up to the 45-yard line. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Give them a lot of credit. They ended up running the ball on a key third down situation. They were staring 3 and out in the face and found a way to flip the script and keep the ball moving on offense.
Let's go! 3-19! 3-19!
When offense now on first down. Caught by the tight end Ertz. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. 15 yards through the air and a first down.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop him?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
Steps away to his left. Going right side here, and that's complete. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
A handoff. It's Mark Ingram. There goes Mark Ingram. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Mark Ingram, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Eagles had six to their lead.
In as many coaches' meetings as we sit in, we hear the word finish all the time, don't we? And on that play, the back actually finished getting into the end zone, breaking the last tackle. Tried to wrap up, tried to use the proper technique, just wasn't able to get it done.
Now the try here for the extra point. The crossbar, and it comes back. A very poor effort from PAT distance. The Eagle kick team out there now as they run up and send this one away. So a very short kick here. This will be taken by one of the up men. And they're going to have really good starting field position here as that's taken up close to the 40. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Grayson now. Bryant with a catch right side. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory.
Face mask. Defense.
Got the hand caught up in the grill of the face mask. 15-yard penalty.
So tough for a defender. You're trying so hard to make a play, and the way that these offensive guys can move around, sometimes your hand gets into the wrong place.
This is Freeman. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. So what will they do? On the ground, through the air, let's see. Second and nine. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. And he'll get it up the middle. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no more. They'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to a third down. And the coach has decided to throw. I'm sure as a coach, when you throw the flag, you hold your breath, then you get the verification you were right, a sigh of relief.
Not only a sigh of relief, a little vindication as well, because every time you pull that red flag and throw it, you could be
under pressure, and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. And a big face mask penalty here of 15 yards.
You never want to get your hands up in the face mask area because your fingers can get tangled up there, and that can hurt you as a player.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And this one complete to Witten over the middle. It's a gain of five on the play, and that'll bring up second down. A 20th carry now for Freeman. And he is going to lose yardage here. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll make it third down.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed. And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
Looking for someone to throw to. And that is incomplete.
Pushing the foul, roughing the passer, defense.
So a big roughing the passer penalty, Charles, and of course that's 15 yards.
And everyone knows how protected the quarterbacks are. You've got to make sure that when you launch at a quarterback, that you're hitting him in the right spot and in the right time.
A handoff, Devontae Freeman. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard that time, second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle, keep coming after them, put the pressure on them.
Now Grayson, that's caught at the 1. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Dez Bryant, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Falcons cut into that lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn it into a play action, and throw one deep.
Here we go now.
Now a play fake here on first down. And this one's incomplete.
Roughing the pass
here, but Charles, that's a good call. But these days, you know quarterbacks, they're very protected.
We know how protected they are, and if it's anything borderline, they're going to get the call. But as a defender, that's hard to swallow sometimes because there's so many of these bang-bang plays.
And oh, look at that, a diving catch. Give him 27 yards that time, and it'll be first down Eagles.
I'd have to say that whenever you see a good post-route run, they do not like to let it end without the catch. Hence, that great diving play.
Yeah, lay it up there, let him go get it, and he got it. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. Wentz now to throw. Oh, that was dangerous. Threw it into coverage, almost picked. But instead, they'll keep it on second down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. Now Wentz throwing on second down. And he rifles one incomplete. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long, with all the targets trying to go after him, he's obviously gotten smart and his pride has kicked in. Made a terrific play.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Now a play fake. Wentz. And Jeffrey's got it. And he carries this one all the way down to the 9. A big gain of 31 on third down. Jeffrey had the franchise tag placed on him in 2016. He's showing why here in this one.
And just think, a number of people thought that he would be a number two receiver his entire time in the NFL. That's not even close to true. He's a number one. You've got to get the ball to him often, as they're doing in this one, and that usually leads to great success, as we're seeing in this game.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
Here we go.
Wentz to throw again. Going underneath, it's Coleman. And inside the five here before he's out of bounds right at the three.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
Here we go now.
Wentz looking to throw on third. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. They've been moving the ball well offensively, really getting into a groove. Last play, pass completion. Now, finally, the defense gets there.
And you have to find a way to disrupt their rhythm. Do you do it with coverage, or do you do it with pressure? They elected to go with pressure, and it was the right call.
So the drive takes them inside the 10, but it ends with just three.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get in.
This will be taken short. And they're going to have really good starting field position here as that's taken up close to the 40. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
They come up in an offset eye. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. Defense maybe trying to guess the snap count there, and it costs them 5 yards. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make this a second down. Grayson now. And this one complete to Winton over the middle. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Now Grayson. And on the left side, he's got Winton. And oh, he coughed it up. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. He didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
He'll drop the throw. And down he goes. A sack. They sack him back across midfield at about the 48-yard line. He was trying to keep his eyes downfield. Nobody came open.
He was trying to do everything that he had been taught, right? Every bit of the technique. But if no one's open, there is no technique except make sure you hold on to the ball as you go to the ground when you're getting sacked.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
But they went for the big play there. But that drop could really hurt their momentum.
There's Matt Bosher now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And now a high kick here as he'll try to hang it up there. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. Here now, another look at the rookie Carson Wentz leading his offense back out there. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes, but right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Everyone's got four down.
All right, here. Throwing now is Wentz. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
But that's the type of pass play that you need to wait for routes to develop. You need a little time in the pocket, but that's hard to do when you got people in your face.
Throwing on second down. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Now that was well defended. And as a cornerback, what you're taught when you see a wide receiver screen, either you get underneath the play before the blocking forms, or you're going to have to fight your way through it by getting through some blocking. That was a really nice play there.
Now Wentz. And this is going to be incomplete.
It's always a good play when you're able to bat a ball away or down, because if you actually tip it in the air, now the offense is getting a second shot at catching the football, or another receiver may come along and grab it out of the air and turn it into a big play. So if you make a play on the ball, make sure it's knocked away or down. Otherwise, there could be some jeopardy.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut it. All right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, if there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Now a handoff. It's Freeman. Oh, what a move. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. And the man who helped Florida State to a national title in 2013, Devontae Freeman, reeling off a nice run.
I remember when he came out of school and I was evaluating him for the NFL draft. I loved a lot of his game. Run it, catch it, block. But I loved how hard he played. He played every play as if it were his last, and that ran him to the Pro Bowl after the 2015 NFL season.
They're going to look to throw. Completes it to Jason Witten, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Jason Witten, his third touchdown now on the year, and the Falcons draw a bit closer.
Remember the one-dimensional tight ends who just put their hand in the ground and block people? Well, if you're that guy now, you're probably a fullback in an I-formation offense. These tight ends nowadays can do everything. Block, run, and catch. Beautiful connection for a touchdown.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag. Because when you do, you just put the ball on it and then let him run.
He's got some space. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. He's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers. And they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
On the left side, it's complete. A really nice gain of 25 yards. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart.
After reviewing the play, the line on the field is reversed.
And the challenge pays dividends. The ref overturns the play.
Everyone gets a bonus on this one, Brandon. The coach upstairs has signaled down and said challenge it, and the head coach for pulling the red flag.
Cutback, left sideline. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. That one goes for 36 yards. And time for us to take a break here in the booth. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. A reminder, coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Larry Ridley will have first half highlights and analysis.
LR, plenty to show in this one.
Going to be a busy man at intermission.
No, check. Patriot!
They come out with one back and three tight ends. Into the red zone. Wentz. Flush to his right. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. A gain of four on the play, and it'll bring up a second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion, or even worse, an interception.
Mike. 53. Check 53.
On play action, it's Wentz. Trying for the tight end, Ertz, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Paul Posluszny. Past the 10 to the 11-yard line, and that's where the return stops. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, gave up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here.
I know tight ends love this route because a lot of times they'll fake a block first and get a little bit of space and then come across the middle because in their mind, they're thinking catch the ball and then drop the hammer on the little guys in the secondary.
Unable to drop the hammer. He just dropped the pass. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. That'll be a gain of 15 yards, and that's going to make it third down and less than a yard. And they're going to speed things up here. Oh, and the hard count might have got him. This might be a first down.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
Too quick to the trigger that time. Neutral zone infraction, and that'll cost him 5 yards. Grayson now. Swings it out to the flat for Freeman. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Charles, I know it's hard when live bullets are flying, but you cannot keep your hand up around the face mask area.
It is absolutely inexcusable nowadays. We talk about target areas all the time. You have to aim lower so that your hand doesn't get involved in the face mask.
To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were. Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Now Grayson surveying the field. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third. Bryant spread out to the right.
Let's go!
Third down, he'll drop to throw to the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
I know they don't like to hear it when they get to a certain age, but then you have to start to use your skills, your wiles, right, your mind to beat guys to the football, and getting your toes tapped inbounds definitely qualifies as that, doesn't it?
The veteran showing he still has the agility. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
And this is one of the risks you run when you attempt a long field goal. If you miss, the defense takes over the spot of the placement. So now they've got a chance to get one more drive in before halftime.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. It's a gain of 17 that time. And the Eagles are going to have a first down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
Green 39.
Wentz now on first down. On the screen, this is Coleman. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. One receiver left, two to the right. From the red zone now, Wentz. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Nelson Aguilar. As the first half is winding down, and the Eagles add on to their lead. And that'll give them a two-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here in the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
He missed one earlier, remember, but this time, he gets it to go. The Eagle kick team out there now as they run up and send this one away. It's a short kick, taken at the 15. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers.
All right, here we go. 3-19! 3-19!
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. They'll look to throw. Trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Ronald Darby. And his guys have got it back in the closing stages of the first half. That late in the clock, second quarter, why not just run it a time or two and get it into the locker room?
What you're saying makes absolutely perfect sense. Run it and get out of there. But I'm just wondering if the pressure of today's NFL and the high-powered offenses that you're facing may have forced them into saying, let's try and get some more points.
And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. The final shot before half for Wentz. He's got time. Try to lay one up deep. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So we have reached halftime here in an 11-point contest. As we send you down to Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Eagles played well en route to a victory last week, and today it's been more of the same. The Falcons are just going to have to try and figure out a way to make a dent in this deficit. So let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Eagles have it at the 7. They'll look to the end zone here, and he finds his mark for the score. That takes the lead up to 12. First and 10, Ingram's got a running lane here, and he's going for the 30-yard touchdown. The lead grows to 15. Midway through the second quarter, here Bryant will make the catch in traffic, and he caps off the 8-play drive with a TD, closing that gap to 8. Down to late in the second. The catch over the middle by Witten. It ends up working for a touchdown. Falcons cut the deficit to 4. Still late stages of the second. Wentz's throw under pressure leads to the turnover. Poslesny's in position, and he's the one who comes away with the ball. Still late stages of the second. Here he'll look into the end zone, and this play will go for 6. The lead now at 11.
And actually, Larry, hold that thought. We're right back to the action. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out come the Eagles now as they'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Offense needs something here on second down. It is second and long. They come up in an offset eye. Wentz to throw on second down. Throwing right, and that's complete. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Nothing flashy there. The slant to the slot.
Oh, and the frustration for the defensive guys, because it's a quick play. And you know it's going to be a bang-bang play in terms of the throw and the catch. And he's able to absorb the contact and complete it.
Throwing now is Wentz. Throwing middle, and it's complete. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even add it a little extra at the end with a short run.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. On second down, here's Wentz. Wide open receiver complete. And he's brought down. They're calling a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
One of the selling points of the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver, and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he fires one incomplete.
A little block in the back. Offense.
They'll come out in the pistol. They go play action here on first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
They don't call them franchise quarterbacks for nothing. And right now, wouldn't it be fun to be in the owner's box and see the reaction after that hit the young guy just took?
Yeah, I was just going to say, especially your young franchise quarterback so many years ahead of him, that's tough to watch sometimes.
It really is. I know in baseball, a lot of the owners used to just call right down into the dugout when they wanted something done. Not sure you can do quite the same thing in the NFL, but I'm sure the message will be sent somehow. Protect that young guy. Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. Just one good carry away from busting this open, that's a good start for him.
So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line giving them time to complete that first down pass.
Again, we'll see the pistol here. Into the red zone. Wentz. He dumps it down to Ingram.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Face mask penalty. And Charles, you were a defender. You know sometimes in the heat of the moment, it's hard to keep your hands away from that face mask.
Sometimes you just get out of position as a defender when you're trying to make a tackle, so you end up flailing away and your hand gets into the wrong spot.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Coleman. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get them in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive line's had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
And did he get the feet down? No. They'll say he did not. It's incomplete. Well, in tapping those toes, he tried to get both in bounds. He could not do it, though.
In tap dance parlance, could not complete the shuffle. All right, needed to get that shuffle down with both feet, not just one.
Is that what they say?
There it is. You know, put a little sand down on the stage.
I'll take your word for it, my man. That's caught at the one. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth. The offense is staying out there. Here we go on fourth and goal from the one. It's Coleman here. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. They stop him up short on fourth and goal from the one. And instead of having a one-score game, they'll remain two scores down.
Partner, when you see a running play stop short like that, you just know that the defensive front, they won the battle of leverage and created the push back in.
And can you believe it? It's a second safety in this ballgame. And this defense continues to dominate. How about two safeties in one game here?
You don't even put that on your goal sheet. This is something that results when you're playing really well on defense and the offense has nowhere to go with the football. Dominating performance.
So a free kick situation forthcoming from the 20 as they'll punt this one away. Carson Wentz, along with his offense, heading back out there for their next possession. And right now, probably just one thing in his mind, it's getting back to the hot start because he's really faded.
And ordinarily when that happens, the quarterback, as you know, is usually the leader of the squad. Now there's probably a silent camaraderie that comes around him saying, hey, guess what? We got you. Don't worry about it. Let's go, big fella. Because they know more times than not, he tends to pick things up and they tend to play well. When it's well executed, a wide receiver screen can often be a thing of beauty, but so many things have to go right in order to complete it. Blocking out in front, timing of the quarterback with the receiver, and oftentimes everything gets set. And guess what? They drop the football.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. So after being silenced a week ago, he's not being silenced here in this one. And you knew a guy like him wouldn't be held down for two straight weeks.
Feels like they just decided to game plan early to get him involved and get him off the schneid. Because you don't want a week like last week to linger. Just get the ball to him early and let him turn in a big-time performance. And that's exactly what he's doing. I don't care what the emphasis is in the NFL at any given time. Every defense is still going to say their number one goal every game is stop the run. And right now, they're not doing that. And that really chips away at your confidence.
And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh shut it down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
So here we go, first and 10 now. They come up with one back. That's Ingram. And he'll get it up the middle. And he's got some space here. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 13 yards there on the pickup. And that leads to a Philadelphia first.
The reason that counter and misdirection plays work so well is that usually you've given them a reason to think that everything's going to the direction it starts initially. You've run that type of a play throughout the game. You give them that look. And now you're going to counter things and bring it back the other way. Almost a tendency breaker at times. And a lot of it is making sure that you have an illusion, almost like a magician. Look over here, but the play is actually happening over there. And that's where a running back's vision comes into play. See the hole in a place where people don't expect and get there with some speed. And that's exactly what he did on that play.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. Now Wentz on 3rd down. Flushed out right. And he connects with Ertz. And he's going to have a 1st down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key 1st down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Second down following the run. They come up in an offset eye. Now Wentz, eluding the pressure right. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a 4th pick, and it's 3rd down. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. And defensively, it's a nickel formation here on third down and nine. Here's Coleman. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. It's a seven-yard run, but it does bring up fourth down. So now here comes the field goal team for the third time today. From the left hash, a chip shot here.
Okay, didn't break that one all the way, but you got to know that he feels like he's right on the verge. And that's probably exactly what he's telling them in the huddle right now.
So three field goals for him here, and this last one helps him stretch out the lead.
And he's been solid as usual. And this is what you need to do. Make sure you get points out of every possession. And so far, they've done a nice job of that.
This will be taken very short. And they're going to have really good starting field position here as that's taken up close to the 40. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get. And it's just so strange to see that go up on the board. And then you got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points. But we all know the guy carrying the ball is going to get the credit, both in the stat line and probably in the newspaper. But guess what? Those guys creating holes, they couldn't feel better about themselves right now. Offensive line, tight end, probably even the wide receivers are involved. They're moving the ball well.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
And a neutral zone infraction on the defense.
The defense thought they had the timing count on the quarterback's cadence, but they jumped too soon.
So we've got encroachment, and that's a free 5 yards.
Too easy for the offense. A bit of impatience by the defense on that one.
Encroachment for defense.
Now it's Freeman. And that play will go nowhere, losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Defense in a good spot. Let's see how the offense responds with a second and 13 now. Now Grayson. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. Well, they've gone backwards so far in this series, third and 13. So not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now. Here's Matt Bosher now as he's on to punt for Atlanta.
Help me out, partner. Was that incomplete?
That was on a deep ball to Dez.
And that's a surprise. The way he attacks the football in the air, it's always surprising to me when he doesn't complete a pass like that.
And problem spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. The Eagles offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped in the contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bash, dude.
Super toe.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. And they're 6 yards away from picking up the first here on second down. Now Wentz throwing on second down. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Illegal block in the back. Offense.
Wentz to throw on second down. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete.
Holding offense.
And that right there will set him back a bit on the offensive holding penalty.
And you know who you want to pressure after a penalty like that? The guy who just committed the foul. You want to see if he's going to keep his head down or if he's going to get his head right back into the game. I'd send a blitz at him right away and see if he holds up.
And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. 11 yards on the pickup, and they'll be facing a third and 12. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. So now a third and 12 with an extra defender here in the secondary. A nickel look on the screen. This is Coleman. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. Now they'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for fourth down. Here we go on fourth down with Wentz. And Jeffrey's got it. And an alley to run. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
We always talk about big-time players make big-time plays in big-time moments. I think that fourth down qualified. That was a heck of a throw.
And now a first down following that long gain. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
Another good run there, and now we're seeing an offense that's imposed its will on a defense. When we talk about that all the time, what does it really mean? It means that the guys on the offensive line, they feel like they can do whatever they want. They're in the huddle saying, run it again. Give us another chance to smack someone and create some space. On the defensive side of the ball, not only have they imposed their will against you, you're almost powerless to figure out what you're doing there, but you got to keep your spirit up at the same time, and they're taking that too.
They come up with one back. That's Ingram. He's going to get the football. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Mark Ingram with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Eagles had six to their lead. He's having a nice little game. Maybe already has an eye on that third touchdown.
And how about what our producer, Christian McLeod, likes to say when they've scored touchdowns like this? He's put a tent up in Touchdown City.
Now the try here for the point after. And it's no good. It has not been his day. That's the second extra point he's missed so far. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be taken short. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Now. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense.
So the roughing the passer penalty, 15 yards. And Charles, the defender, needs to know to stop there.
We've been talking about it for years. You essentially get one step after the quarterback throws his pass. Anything close to that or beyond that, you're going to get flagged.
False start, offense.
little play fake here on first down. And on the left side, he's got Witten. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. They'll give him a yard on the play, and that's going to make it second and 14. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And this is caught by Witten, the tight end. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Bryant spread out to the right.
Let's go! 319!
Now flags come flying in. One of the Falcons moved early.
False start. Offense.
The offense behind the chains after the infraction. It's now third down and 14. Now Grayson. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. They got pressure there and only rushing three.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with three there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You're dropping eight. Where are you going to go with the football?
He'll field this at the five. Oh, spinning away.
Illegal block in the back. Return team.
First is Wentz. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
They go play action here on first down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. So holding by the offense, and maybe now got to shift up what you want to do on the playbook.
Yeah, definitely. Change what you're doing in the playbook, but boy, the advantage shifts to the guys on defense, doesn't it? Longer yardage situations, they often become bolder.
And he'll take this one only up to about the 21. 2 yards on the pickup, it'll be second down. Second down, here's Wentz. His throw incomplete. They come out with one back and three tight ends. After the penalty, it's Ingram. And he'll get this one up to about his 14. He'll get three, but it leaves him with a big hole here on third and very long. And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run. Now a play fake. Wentz. And that is incomplete. Here's Donnie Jones now, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone. fair catch called for and taken right near the 30-yard line. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And out will come the offense as they take over. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helps to have a guy who can turn it loose. And, boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Here we go now. Blue lady. Blue lady.
Here's Freeman. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
Outside handoff to the right side. If you're a running back, you love getting the ball early so you have vision to see what's happening in front of you.
Right tackle likes that call. Big play for him. But don't forget about the guys you always tell me in the backside sealing off.
When they talk about cutoff blocks, making sure no one can leak from the backside, they can run a play down.
And nobody leaked. Big play. In the books. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four. Grayson now. And this one complete to Witten over the middle. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. Last week, as you get a look at some of the numbers, he just wasn't in the mix, almost like he was out of the game plan. We couldn't figure out why, but here, he's fully in the game plan.
I like what you just brought up, because when we asked the coaches about that, it was a little sheepish in there, wasn't it? That's what they admitted, yeah. We kind of neglected him last week. We've got to find ways to get him the football, scheme to get him open, because they know he's a big-time weapon, so they're going to have people out there to cover him. But sometimes you just have to do some things, show some different formations, get him isolated where he can be one-on-one. And in this game, they're getting that done.
Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. And here comes play number six on this drive. So here we go now. An extra defensive back in there on third and ten. They'll look to throw again. And that will be incomplete as well.
Pushing the foul. Roughing the passer. Defense.
Roughing the passer, that's shades of Charles Davis back in his playing days.
Oh, I sure wish it had been, Brandon. Back in my day, I didn't hit anyone hard enough to rough the passer. I had a number of teammates that handled that for me.
Coming left, it's Freeman. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight. Jason Witten, the intended target, and it's third down. Eighth play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. This will be caught at about the five. Just a 5-yard pickup, but it leads to fourth down.
so much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they've rallied and made the tackle.
All right, here we go.
Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. And now another turnover as this one's intercepted. Picked off by Ronald Darby. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Yardage back at the 17. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
The insistence of speed at every position is really seen at the defensive end spot. These guys in old days were often outside linebackers. They just pushed them forward because they wanted to play fast and get to the
ball. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. They push him back 8 yards that time on second down.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
We got four. All right, here we go.
On play action, it's Wentz. Backing up. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Holding offense.
Here's Donnie Jones now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Taking it about the 36. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And it'll be Falcon football as they take possession. Here now we look at Jason Witten. And this is how the game has trended for him numbers-wise. He's really picked it up, and I got to be honest, I don't know schematically. This is where I need you. What does the defense need to do to get back to that start that they had on him?
You've got to harass him early in his route. Right off the line of scrimmage, someone needs to be there so it's not what we call a free release where he just gets into the route so easily. Because once he builds up momentum and speed, forget it, you're done. Knock him off of that, chip away at his timing, and then make sure you have a second person there in the vicinity as well. Too big and too strong, usually, for one person to handle.
Now Grayson. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight. Doesn't really matter because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
But we just saw the recipe for success right there. Big body, strong, agile, playing with great leverage and hands. Not really able to be blocked on that play. Close things down inside.
Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Trying to get that in the hands of Devontae Freeman that time. And it's third down. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Complete to Jason Witten. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence, and that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
They'll run here with Freeman. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down.
While there was no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window. And they've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
Second down, offense behind the sticks here. Second and 13. Again, it'll be Freeman. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Only a couple yards there, and that's going to set up a long third and goal.
I have to laugh a little bit because he actually handed it off. I thought with the two touchdown passes he's thrown in this one already, he'd go ahead and fling and try and get a third one.
Yeah, now from this spot on third down, I think he'd probably throw it here.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question about it. They won't even send in a running play here, I don't believe. I think they go ahead and try and throw it for a touchdown.
Oh, and the defender took some liberties there with a late hit, roughing the passer.
The league has done a great job of defining what is a late hit. An illegal contact on a quarterback, the defenders really have to get in line.
Now flags come flying in. One of the Falcons moved early.
False start, offense.
Take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman, his second touchdown on the season. And the Falcons get a bit closer. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
So they go with a pass, and it works there on the two-point try. Charles, just in general, what are your thoughts, passing versus running on two-point conversion? Situational?
It is situational, and you have to know your team. What is your strength? Because so many people think you have to throw the ball on a two-point conversion, but the stats will tell you that running it is about as proficient. So know your team and go to your strength.
And out now come the Eagles. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Now Wentz, able to get away.
That's why you keep the legs churning.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. So third and seven and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
Oh, he's got a man wide open. Complete. A gain of 11 and a first down. Coleman. Oh, look at the juke. And he'll cut it out to the sideline. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. Down. And his throw is incomplete.
Holding offense.
So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
They go play action here on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
on any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
Again, it's Wentz. And he comes back with one complete. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down. Third down now following the completed pass. He's played a great game. It continues right there, even with this lead, confident to throw the pass and have the reception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is there? There's no doubt who they want to ride all the way to the finish. The strategy would tell you run the football, run the clock down. Instead, they're letting him throw it because they feel that confident in what he's getting done. And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
Oh, so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late top.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackler was there right away for a loss of yardage.
Wentz to throw on second down. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long.
Here we go. 3-19.
Now Wentz on third down. Hard throw, incomplete. And the dreaded face mask penalty, that's going to cost him 15 yards.
And it's such a dangerous play. Body going one way, and then your head gets yanked back the other. 15 yards is the right call.
Now it's a giant. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33.
Holding offense.
So he got his hands a little too far outside. The ref caught him, threw the flag. Following the flag, first and 20 now.
Over. Here we go now.
From the gun, it's Wentz. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And after a nice game, they don't need the penalty. They'll decline it, take the ball where the play resulted. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to push his way down to about the 12.
They need to block in the back. Offense.
First and 15 here behind the chains. Throwing now is Wentz. Sliding out of the pocket. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football, because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
And this is incomplete. Good job by the O-line. Quarterback had time to go through his checks. That's one you need to take advantage of.
A perfect situation, and they're unable to take advantage of it. When you have that much time to scan the field, you have to find an open receiver.
Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a fourth pick of the game. And now fourth down.
I know ultimately that feels like a good defensive play, but I know it's really not. They had a chance to keep points off the board. Now they have a chance to kick a field goal by missing that shot.
Yeah, especially at this spot in the field. He's got to be upset he couldn't come up with that INT. So they'll turn to the kicker again. He's been a busy man thus far. This to make it a 3-score game late. I don't think this will even, nope, it doesn't even get there. Well short, and this score will stay right where it is. So now from a defensive perspective, they might still have a pulse.
Yeah, that probably would have sealed their fate, but now they're still within 2 scores.
Now Grayson finding time. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. So a little grabbing there, but this time it goes against the offense for holding. They'll wind up losing a full 10 yards on the play.
Here we go now.
Grayson now. He's got time in the pocket. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Juke spin move, not a great deal there on the back end, but a nice gain still. Second down now after the pass completion. Bryant spread out to the right.
Here we go.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw, and his pass incomplete. Now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And this one hits at the 3 and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. Comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. Well, let's face it, we've been there. We've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
Wentz now on first down. Escaping the pressure right. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense.
So roughing the passer, 15-yard penalty.
And you notice how the offensive line responded. A couple went to check on the quarterback, and a couple went to the guy who hit the quarterback. No one likes to see their quarterback hit.
Quick throw, that's complete on the inside slam. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and it'll make it second down. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he's brought down. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
When a coaching staff sees their team run the ball this successfully in the fourth quarter, they're really excited because you can plan for a running game all you want, and want to press that advantage when you get it. But for the most part, it's a little bit of a surprise. And right now, they've got to keep that going, want to continue to grind out the clock because it's definitely in their favor at this stage of the game. Can they close the game out and continue to do exactly what we just saw there, and that's run the football?
So the offense looking at a second and eight. Now Wentz throwing on second down. And his throw here is incomplete.
Holding offense.
So oftentimes you see defensive holding. Here it's offensive holding for the flag. Wentz to throw on second down. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. A great read, and it's picked off. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. That is the play they needed in a two-score game here in the fourth quarter.
No doubt about it. They did what they had to do to give themselves a chance to get back into the game. They turned it over to the offense. They are now in charge.
Now they need to execute. A good start there on this fourth quarter drive. They need more of what we just saw.
Down a couple of scores. There's still time, all right? It's not like they're totally out of it, but they have to score quickly, and they're going to need some big-time plays, chunk plays, explosive plays. They need yardage on each snap.
Going right side. He has Witten. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Ronald Darby. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line. And that gives him now 3 interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get 3 in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's
then
right.
Then the Eagles.
That's right. Then
nowhere to go. Here he lost the football. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
And you really can't pin that one on the quarterback, Charles. The O-line, they've got to protect that.
And they know it. That's their meal ticket. They want to take care of the big guy behind them. In this case, they let him down.
False start, offense.
So the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's second and long. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he comes back with one complete. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. And that last reception puts him over 150 yards. So tough to cover a big tight end like that.
It changes the chalk, as one of my coaches like to say, meaning the normal things don't apply. I used to say, okay, there's a tight end going out. We're either going to put a big linebacker on him or maybe a safety and call it a day. Now, because of the strength of that position and the sheer number of catches that they make as well as their dexterity, sometimes you have to put a cornerback on him because he might be the primary guy going out for a pass. It changes what they do defensively, and it's usually not good for the defense.
An encroachment penalty here, maybe just a mental lapse, partner.
Sometimes you have to just watch the football. Make sure it's snapped before you're jumping.
So we've got a 2nd and 5.
Let's go. Green, 39.
Now Grayson. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And eventually brought down, but it's near the 5 at the 6. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there, and how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
The man with over 1,000 catches, Jason Witten, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
Well, the pressure, the hits, the sacks have been coming at him all game long. I'm frankly surprised that they haven't found a solution yet to create more time for him to throw it or maybe change what they do on offense.
And that's one of the biggest differences in this game and why they're losing right now.
False start, offense.
Bryant spread out to the right. Grayson now. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Malcolm Mitchell, his second touchdown on the season. And the Falcons have cut it to within a score.
Okay, I know it's an old line, but it still applies here. The fat lady has not sung yet. She may be warming up, but she hasn't sung yet. There's still an opportunity.
Yeah, after the touchdown, here's Bryant now to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
You always hear about empty possessions. Some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, pump the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
My high school coach, John Ford, used to say all the time, if you're in a bad situation, laddie, don't compound it with a bad decision as well. And I think that's what we just saw there. Harassed in the pocket, and he throws into double coverage anyway.
He called you laddie?
He called me laddie, and that's the nicest thing he called me.
Now Wentz. Aguilar has it. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Time for a break. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And on the ground they go with a running back. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Let's see what the offense comes with here, second and 8. They come up with 1 back. That's Ingram. And he'll get it up the middle. And he'll take this. And the Falcons going to use another timeout. That'll be their second, so 1 more chance to stop the clock here. And we'll be back. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. To throw is Wentz. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on 4th down. They'll run it with Coleman. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. The Eagles unable to convert there on 4th. And this defense will take over right near midfield at the 49-yard line. So out come the Falcons now. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series.
That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
Back to throw. Looking sideline, incomplete. A long way to go here for the offense on third down after the penalty. Third and 15. He'll look to throw. He completes it to Bryant. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Back to throw. To the right side, it's caught by Mitchell. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
They'll look to throw, and this one complete to Witten over the middle. And he's going to be taken down, but not before reaching the 15-yard line. They're going to hurry back to the line now. He's back to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Now flags come flying in. One of the Falcons moved early.
Foster offense.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Bryant spread out to the right.
Here we go.
Now Grayson. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. 7th play of the drive upcoming here on 3rd and 6. Grayson now. This will be caught at about the 5. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Malcolm Mitchell in the final minute. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game.
And while it appears the heavy lifting was accomplished by scoring the touchdown, they're still down 1. That extra point is not a gimme.
So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this 4th quarter. And this will be a touchback. Last year would have come out to the 20. This year they'll move it out to the 25-yard line. Now here's the Falcons defense getting set to go again. They're trying, Charles, just to simply preserve this tie at this point. I mean, well, they take a turnover, pick 6, but they're trying to hold on to that tie.
No doubt about it, and they have to stay on alert here in case they try and run something big. Some teams are really gamblers. They want to get after it a little bit, make sure that doesn't happen. And also, if you're the offensive team, you might think to yourself, let's just get to overtime. Take a knee and let's get out of here.
Yeah, they have a decision. They could play it conservative or maybe a little more liberal. Wentz to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. 2nd down now after the incompletion. Back to throw. Wentz. And this one incomplete. So the clock stopped now with 20 seconds remaining.
Give him credit for batting it away, but unable to come up with the interception. And sometimes that joke does come true. Guys are on defense for a reason. Maybe their hands aren't quite as skillful as the guys on offense, but a lot of credit on that play for just knocking it away.
Surveying the field. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
It'll be called just a 22-yard punt, certainly not what he wanted. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before we hit triple zeros. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against?
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
So the hard count gets them there, neutral zone infraction.
Yeah, the defense thought they had the timing down, but the quarterback hit them with a hard count, got them to jump.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. He'll drop to throw. He's got time. He's going to float this one deep right side. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense. That penalty is declined.
And with the lead, no chance of a return spoiling this one here on the PAT. It is up and through, and there is your final margin of victory is on the final play. They win it by a touchdown. Well, that was a fun game to witness, partner. A touchdown there at the very end to win this thing.
And that's really where the emphasis is, right? The touchdown to win it. I know that they put a little on top, right? What's your favorite dessert? You know, what do you want? What do you put on top of your favorite dessert?
Put whipped cream. Maybe a cherry.
There you go. The whipped cream, the cherry, whatever you want to talk about, that's what they put on it. But the story, the touchdown to win it, that's how they got it done.
So for the Falcons, the win for them is number 6 on the year. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for the Eagles, it's their first double of the season as they'll dip to 8-1 on the year. And they'll be on the road next week as they get a date with the Seahawks in Seattle. So that'll do it for us, for my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our...
You're cracking dawn, Monday morning coffee strong, pouring everything you got into a paycheck Friday night. Your power stroke, diesel, backhoe, riding king, 18-wheeler driving, living life in between the lines of clocking in and quitting time. But then the six-string circus comes to town, we hang them speakers over the crowd. When the lights come on, everybody's screaming, lighters in the sky, and everybody's singing, every word to every song of the girl they're taking. Same page cause we sipping the same drink. But here's a little something to thank y'all for showing up. Al Dean and the boys are about to blow it up. When the lights come on, everybody.
Three chains. Ow.
Caught up in my put your head on backwards and skate off after engaging laughter about what just happened. Napkins get sent to mammies, is that too graphic? Catch you in traffic, you sitting dappy like stealing candy. My ceiling's absent, my wheels are massive, my friends assassins. All of us, our mothers queens and our women dancers. My river's rapping, my fin is splashing, my gills are flapping. I bit some matches and sip some tin and kiss the dragon.
I'm really rapping, no fingers snapping, them packing. Y'all slipping, my swag is dripping, so here's a napkin. What's really happening, verbal attacking, I'm showing passion. Know what I mean, see, I'm the king like I'm from Akron. I'm going overboard, somebody happened, and when it